मैनेजमेंट ऑडिट। व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट ऑडिट? ऑडिट ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट डिसीजंस। देन व्हाट अबाउट द ऑपरेशनल ऑडिट? मैनेजमेंट एंड ऑपरेशनल ऑडिट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एंड सप्लीमेंट्री टू वन अनदर। इज इट करेक्ट? इट वॉज आस्क्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन ऑल्सो। मैनेजमेंट ऑडिट एंड ऑपरेशनल ऑडिट इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री। Supplementary. To one another. Complementary example, general example. I will give general example. It's like milk and tea powder. You can make tea, right? Tea powder and milk. Supplementary. Tea or coffee. You can use tea or you can use coffee. If you use both of these also, milk and tea, you will get the tea. You can substitute tea or coffee. You can use any one of these. So it management audit is like operation audit is like a complementary and supplementary to one another. Management audit is concerned with the quality of the management. Management audit is concerned with the quality. So management audit is mainly concerned with the quality of the managing, whereas the operational audit is concerned with the which is mainly concerned with the quality of the operations. So here managing, here operations. The basic difference between the two audits is not method. Method can be same. There is no difference with that. But the main difference is the basic difference between these two audits is in the level of appraisal. Level of appraisal. In the management audit, the auditor evaluates the decision taken at the level of the top management. Top level management's decisions. In the case of the management audit, evaluation of the top management decision. What kind of decisions? It can be with regard to formulation of objectives. Or plans or policies. So this is with regard to the management audit. So in management audit, auditor evaluates the decision taken at the level of the top management. It can be formulation of objectives, formulation of plans or a formulation of policies. What about the operational auditor? Next page. Operational audit. In this case, auditor evaluates effectiveness, efficiency and the economy of operations under management's control. It can be effectiveness, efficiency or economy. Effectiveness, efficiency or economy of operations under management's control. So this is the auditor evaluates. Auditor evaluates the efficiency, effectiveness, economy of the operations under management's control. So it can recommend, also it can recommend improvement. So along with the recommendations for improvement, so this is with regard to the basic difference. Again, what is the basic difference? Basic difference is not about the method. Method will be the same, but the basic difference is in the level of the appraisal. Next comes management audit program. For this plan of action, so first plan of action is devising a statement of policy. Statement of policy. So in consultation with the top management, the policy should ideally cover scope, objective, authority of the management audit function. So with the consultation top management, this statement of policy should cover scope, objective and authority of the management audit function. Next comes location of the audit function within the organization. Location of audit function within the organization. This is a hierarchical status of the management auditor, where he fits in. Location in the cells, the hierarchical status. Not only auditor and his team also. It should be clearly defined. Next comes third point, allocation of personnel. The management audit team should comprise of a personnel who have adequate experience on various aspects of the organization. So whatever the management audit team has, personnel has, should have experience . Fourth one, staff training. So in order to maintain the quality standards, adequate continuous training should be offered to management audit team. So in order to maintain qualitative standards, adequate and continuous training. In order to maintain qualitative standards, training is important. Adequate training and continuous training. Training, adequate and continuous, should be required. That is all about the staff training. Fifth point, time and other aspects. Adequate consideration should be given to time and the cost involved in the conducting the audit. Time and the cost. What is the time and the cost involved in the audit should be considered. That is with regard to the fifth point. Last point is the frequency of audit. How many times frequency audit, when should be audit is required, should be determined on the basis of the changes in the industry. When there is a changes in the industry and in consultation with the top level management whenever required. Top management. So these are the 6 points. Devising the statement of policy in consultation with the top management. The policy should ideally cover the scope, objective, authority of the management audit function. Second comes location of the audit function within organization. The hierarchical status of the management auditor and his team should be clearly defined. Allocation of the personnel. The management audit team should comprise of personnel who have adequate experience on various aspects of the organization. Staff training. In order to maintain qualitative standards, adequate and